I don't think I'll ever be able to enjoy biryani in my life ever again. That's how strong this film is. Hello guys, I'm Nona Prince and today we're talking about the Malayalam film Biryani. It's available on Cave Stream India, written and directed by Sajin Babu, starring Kanni Kusruti. This film went to a lot of film festivals and won many awards and was a special jury mention in the National Awards. There'll be spoilers in the video about the film. After watching the film, no wonder the film is not available on a big OTT platform. Not just because it's an adult film, even if you censor them, what the film is showing will offend a lot many people. And with the current situation in the country, I don't think any OTT platform will risk showing this. It's such a raw film. Like, there were scenes in the film I never wanted to see in my life, but I had no choice. They came out of nowhere on the screen. I'm not a bio student, I didn't like bio, and it was pretty hard to watch some of the scenes in the film. The film definitely has that indie vibe to it. You can tell there were budget constraints on them, and I could notice some technical glares also. Really like the disclaimer at the start of the film, which says this film is not representing authentic Kerala or authentic biryani. Nice touch. Now, I have mixed thoughts about the film. I'm all over the place. It's a film which stays with you for a long time and, you know, makes you think and guess what it was all about. Of course, the obvious one is the terrorism angle, and I have to tell you, I have no understanding of this subject, so I don't want to go into it much. I knew about this terrorism element in Kerala. We also saw some of it in Family Man, but that's the extent of my knowledge about it. So I'm no expert on it and I don't want to comment anything about it, because most of it leads to the politics, which the film depicts also, with all those snippets in the news debate. And I liked every side was given a chance in it. But this film focuses on how the family suffers, especially the women of the family. First of all, they are living in a patriarchal society. Then they belong to a religion and community which is heavily radical in today's time, is a minority, so there is a prejudice against them in the society, and they have to tackle all of this. And over that, there's a class difference. They are poor, and we follow her life and her struggles. Have to look after an ailing mother because of the terrorist link with the family. She's divorced, left alone. The society and the community have boycotted them, and then there are all these hawks in the society waiting to take advantage of her, and how finally she starts to climb up the ladder. I think the film very well captures the society and the environment, which is very important to understand what she is going through in the film. Now, when the film begins, she starts with being under someone, and by the end, she's at the top. And we see throughout the film how did this transition happen. Before continuing, if you're finding value in the video, do consider hitting the like button, because when you do that, YouTube promotes this video and more people can watch it. Also, consider subscribing and hit the bell icon to get notification whenever a new video drops. Now, I did feel lost at some moments in the film, because some of the things that happened in the film, I couldn't understand the meaning behind them. Before the climax, I was kind of expecting something like RUV, the Tamil movie, but it didn't go that way. And when the climax happens, oh my god, which has ruined biryani for me now. I understand her motivation of doing it, but I'm trying to find out what was the filmmaker's motivation of showing that. What was the meaning behind it? And we were discussing about this film on Discord, and there were various answers to it, like, you know, she wanted to feed her flesh to them because they all wanted her flesh. And that kind of makes sense. After the climax, there's a scene on the beach where she's feeding the dogs. So I was correlating that with the climax. She had invited all the big powerful people to her party, and most of those people had wronged her. So, you know, I'm trying to connect the dots, but I'm not able to get to an answer. Now, when she's on the beach, we see four people flying kites, and one of those four people is a girl. And when Khadija leaves the beach, the camera focuses on that girl. Now, I'm wondering what are they trying to say. Is her future bright, or will she also go through all of these issues in society? Because in a way, the film shows the struggles a woman has to go through. So is it a hopeful ending, or is it a sad reality? I don't know. And at the end, she commits suicide, but then we see her alive with the ex-husband. I was just so confused, like, what happened here? Is it a flashback kind of a thing? But then Bane on Discord came up with the theory that there's a dialogue in the film where she says that if a man dies, he goes to heaven and there are 72 angels waiting for him. But what about a woman? And maybe this is her heaven, where she's at the top, she has the power, she's smiling, she has the control. And I like that theory, it makes a lot of sense. Let me know what you guys think. Coming to the acting, Kanni Kusruti was really good. It was a really bold film to do for various reasons. I recently saw her in OK Computer and she did really well there. And yesterday only I found out that she and Anand Gandhi are together. That's great. Suhara Baby, who played the mother, was really good too. And most of the secondary cast did a satisfactory job. Again, very interesting film. A lot of things are going on. A lot of metaphors definitely, which I have missed. And also a lot of cultural things which I may not know. And it's not every day that you get a film about the Muslim community. The last one I remember watching was Halal Love Story. And I don't think any other industry apart from Malayalam cinema focuses on that. So, you know, it's good to get these stories, to know other side of things. Not a mind-blowing film for me, but a great attempt. Will I ever watch it again? No, never. I cannot go through it again. I can't even think of biryani anymore. So guys, that is the video. If you like this, hit the thumbs up button, share this video, let me know in the comments your thought. If you haven't subscribed yet, check out the videos if you like them too. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.